The beach and nightlife may be a big draw for millions of tourists who visit San Diego every year.
San Diego is incredibly beautiful, but it's the time now to insert a soul into the city.
The soul that Ann Berchtold and Julie Schrager are talking about is a vibrant, culturally diverse community that receives economic support from its thriving fine art. The two women launched the first Beyond the Border International Contemporary Art Fair in 2009 with that in mind. The fair brought in 27 galleries, 2,500 people attended the three-day event, and 70% of the galleries sold their artwork.
We have an opportunity to thread in a strong cultural foundation. If we miss it, we're gonna go the way of Las Vegas and just become, you know, a nightclub city. So it's kind of the motivation behind the fair.
The fair is being held beginning September 2nd at the Hilton Bayfront. The hope is to double attendance to some 5,000 attendees and create 500 hotel room night stays. The women say as they increase the event, they know city officials will take note.
10% of them came from Arizona, Orange County, Palm Desert area, and then local.
The way collectors are purchasing art is changing.
Art fair, it's like sex, drugs, and rock and roll for the art world. It's fun. You can go, and I call it speed dating for the art collector. You know, you can have a very non-committal relationship with a gallerist and see about five of them and be drinking a glass of champagne and talking to dynamic, interesting art, you know, museum directors and artists. It pulls together everybody, I think, in a really fun, fresh format.
The women say the fair environment is less intimidating for art collectors. And in these tough economic times, when galleries are being forced to close their shops, it's leaving the door wide open for the Beyond the Border Fair to establish its roots in San Diego.
I think a lot of the galleries that we've talked to are definitely doing more of these fairs and finding that it's become, you know, very lucrative for them, and in some cases, some to the extent where they've actually just closed their physical presence and just touring and attending fairs.
I would love to one day just step behind the scenes and see 10,000 international people drinking champagne, looking at great art, and just in San Diego. That would be a really exciting day for me, you know, to see the city kind of ramp up and be something other than just a beachy town.
For Art Pulse TV, I'm Phoebe Chong Chua.